YouTube. Sir Dragon X here, coming to you from the beautiful island of Cozumel. We're going to explore this beautiful island in the video coming up next.
Today, we're going to explore the city of Cozumel, Mexico, and an island and municipality in the Caribbean Sea off the eastern coast of Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula opposite Playa del Carmen. It is separated from the mainland by the Cozumel Channel. The municipality is part of the state of Quintana Roo, Mexico. Today, we're going to explore this beautiful island. Before we start, just a reminder to visit us at our new website at www.retiredlifeinmexiconoble.com. Subscribe to this channel and visit us on social media at the links listed in the description of this video and the description of our channel. Cozumel is an island that's about 30 miles long and 9.9 miles wide with a total area of 184 square miles. It is Mexico's largest Caribbean island, largest permanently inhabited island, and Mexico's third largest island. The majority of the island's population lives in a little town called San Miguel de Cozumel with a population of approximately 88,600 inhabitants, which is located on the island's western shore. The island is also rich in history and dates back to the Mayan civilization. The Maya are believed to have first settled Cozumel in 300 AD. The island was a sacred to Ixchel, the Maya moon goddess, and the temples were a place of pilgrimage, especially by women desiring fertility. There are still ruins that remain on the island to this day. The Spanish first arrived in Cozumel in 1518 and utilized the island as a stop to resupply their ships while traveling on their expeditions. Up to 10,000 Mayans actually lived on the island up until this point, but in 1520, an infected crew from a Spanish expedition brought smallpox to the island, and by 1570, only 186 Maya men and 172 Maya women were left alive on Cozumel. In 1849, the town of San Miguel de Cozumel was settled and founded and was officially recognized by the Mexican government. Cozumel is a popular cruise ship port of call famed for its scuba diving. At Arrecifes de Cozumel National Park, there are diving spots around a section of a Mesoamerican reef, and the Museo Subacuático de Arte, there are submerged sculptures you can go see while scuba diving. Chacanab is an eco park surrounded by a lagoon with underwater caverns, home to dolphins, manatees, and sea turtles. There are plenty of fun activities to do. Not only scuba diving, but snorkeling is very popular. Thanks to Pink Tours Cozumel, we went on a snorkeling tour that was amazing, and we're going to show some clips from that snorkeling tour. Now, if you're a scuba diver, this place has some of the best scuba diving locations in all of Mexico. Not only is it famous for scuba diving in all of Mexico, it's also famous throughout the world as one of the finest scuba diving locations. And if you don't want to scuba dive, like I said, you can just snorkel like we did. I enjoyed the beautiful reefs. We swam with the fishes, and we even got to see starfishes, live starfishes. If you shop around, these marine tours that'll take you snorkeling can be had for as little as 700 pesos. There's also a rich history. There's churches around here that were built in the 1500s. Not only is there snorkeling and scuba diving, but there's several little towns that you can visit. Each little town has artisan stuff that you can buy, and also one of the towns, there was an actual Mayan ruin there. Now, getting around the island, you can either take a taxi everywhere, or you can rent a car. It's very affordable. We rented a car for a Jeep, actually, for approximately $50 a day. As far as food, the seafood is fresh. We actually had fresh lobster. It was divine. Now, you may ask, how do you get to this island since it's not on the mainland? Basically, you have to fly into the Cancun airport. From the Cancun airport, there's several options. You can either take a taxi, a shuttle, or they have the ADO bus. Now, the most affordable option, which we took, was the ADO bus. The buses are clean and very luxurious. Now, the most expensive option is a taxi, which we've taken in the past, which has run us over 1,000 pesos. Now, once you take a taxi, a shuttle, or a bus, the trip is approximately 1 hour to Playa del Carmen, where there's a ferry that goes across to Cozumel. Basically, there's a ferry that crosses every hour from the hours of 7 a.m. till 10 p.m. The approximate cost is 215 pesos, and the ride on the ferry is approximately 30 to 45 minutes. Once you arrive in Cozumel, there's plenty of transportation options back to your hotel. There's taxis right there outside of the terminals. There's also rental car stands where you can rent a car or a Jeep. Now, enough with the talking. Let's explore the beautiful island of Cozumel. And thanks, Pink Tours Cozumel, for the wonderful snorkeling tour.